Why was I created? You know, why am I on this earth? How should I use my days on earth?
Every night after he would finish studying, he would call and we would talk. It was so wonderful because the first thing he would ask me is, what did I do that day?
I think in many ways I fell in love with her when I first saw her. I sort of felt like there was something there that would make me want to hang around for a very long time. Absolutely committed ourselves from the day one that we wanted to be rich. It's difficult for the rich to get into the kingdom, but not impossible. So I didn't mind the challenge.
And I saw that company grow from about 15 employees to over 200, and it was a phenomenon. We would have staff meetings, management meetings at 6 o'clock in the morning, but he and his partner were there by 5 o'clock or even earlier.
The business was all consuming for me. Go down to the office, spend all day long there, come home, eat supper, go back to the office. I became so consumed, she was virtually abandoned.
Finally realized that those things, the big car and the closet full of clothes, weren't really giving me lasting happiness.
She came and sat on the side of our king-size bed one day and told me she didn't love me anymore.
It was a risk for me to say, I can't live this way anymore.
We were going to fundamentally change our lives, including giving away everything we had and making ourselves poor again.
Maybe I'll be there to shake your hand. Maybe I'll be there to share the land that be given away when we all live together. I'm talking about together now.
Clarence said, if you are going to be an authentic disciple of Jesus, you have to take Jesus seriously, try to understand what his message really was about, and incorporate it in our daily lives. And that is why we started building houses. That was a relevant need.
Hello, I'm Millard Fuller, director of Habitat for Humanity.
The former millionaire gave away his fortune to build for God.
The challenge is this, to end poverty housing.
Habitat for Humanity is a catchy phrase.
Habitat for Humanity.
Habitat for Humanity.
The mandate that we feel from God is to make it possible for everybody to have a decent place to sleep.
What kind?
No more run-down tenements. We want no more garbage-strewn ghettos, which are a disgrace to America the Beautiful and to civilized humanity.
Should there be people or peoples? Money, funny pedestals for fools who never pay. Raise your army, choose your steeple. Don't be shy, the satellites can look the other way. Lose the earthquakes, keep the faults. Fill the oceans without the salt. Let every man own his own hand.
The word spread fast today that the founder and president of Habitat for Humanity, Millard Fuller, and his wife, co-founder of the nonprofit organization, were fired.
Habitat for Humanity, it helps build homes for those in need and has fired its founder.
you know, we've lost our jobs, and the press is outside, and they're all wanting interviews, and the phone is ringing.
Hello, Mr. Fuller. This is Leslie Brown again from A Current Affair.
Mr. Fuller, my name is David Lukowitz. I'm with the Fox News Channel.
I want to tell you something. A house is fundamental. A house is a foundation stone on which human development occurs.
Let us lay aside those political and those religious differences, and let us pick up the tool of Jesus, which was a hammer.